In recent years, there has been a surge in investments in renewable technologies, particularly in the United States. At the forefront of this movement is commercial geothermal energy, which offers triple advantage as an energy source for heating, cooling, and power generation. This versatile source has captured the attention of researchers, policymakers, and industry leaders alike, sparking a wave of innovation and investment. According to a report by Bloomberg, climate tech spending in 2023 witnessed a remarkable increase, signifying a growing commitment to combating climate change and transitioning towards cleaner energy sources. From the research labs to the boardrooms, the potential of geothermal energy is being recognized and harnessed in unprecedented ways. Geothermal energy is not just a source of power. It is a storage resource, a mineral resource, and a solution to decarbonization challenges. Research from the National Renewable Energy Laboratory, NREL, underscores the immense potential of geothermal energy in providing clean, reliable power while reducing greenhouse gas emissions. Geothermal energy has long been overshadowed by other renewables like solar and wind, but its unique attributes make it an immense resource to the energy transition. Geothermal energy offers a sustainable solution for heating and cooling, particularly in urban areas where energy demand is high. I explained how geothermal works in other videos in more depth. There are three basic designs for geothermal power plants, all of which pull hot water and steam from the ground, use it, and then return it for higher efficiency. In the simplest design, known as dry steam, the steam goes directly through the turbine, then into a condenser, where the steam is condensed into water. In a second approach, very hot water is depressurized or flushed into steam, which can then be used to drive the turbine. In the third approach, called a binary cycle system, the hot water is passed through a heat exchanger where it heats a second liquid, such as isobutane, in a closed loop. Isobutane boils at a lower temperature compared to water, so it is more easily converted into steam to run the turbine. The choice of which design to use is determined by the resource. If the water comes out of the well as steam, it can be used directly as in the first design. If it is hot water and the temperature is high enough, a flash system can be used. Otherwise, it must go through a heat exchanger. Since there are more hot water resources than pure steam or high-temperature water sources, there is more growth potential in the binary cycle heat exchanger design. The majority of geothermal energy is used for electricity generation rather than direct heat applications. Globally, around 80% of geothermal energy is used for electricity production, while approximately 20% is utilized for direct heating purposes. However, these percentages can vary depending on regional factors such as resource availability, technological capabilities, and energy demands. The differing approaches to geothermal energy utilization among countries are shaped by their unique geological conditions, energy prices, energy policies, and technological capabilities. While in the United States, geothermal energy is primarily used for electricity generation rather than direct heat applications, in Sweden and Germany, geothermal energy predominantly is used for direct heating applications rather than electricity generation, given that the country's favorable geothermal conditions and energy priorities. The U.S. has access to large geothermal reservoirs, particularly in western states like California, Nevada, and Hawaii, where high-temperature geothermal fluids can be targeted to produce electricity through geothermal power plants. Additionally, the U.S. has invested heavily in geothermal technology for electricity generation, making it a viable and cost-effective option. Sweden and Germany have fewer high-temperature geothermal resources suitable for electricity generation. Instead, they have focused on utilizing geothermal energy for direct heating applications, such as district heating and residential heating. This is because even though they may not have access to high temperature reservoirs, they can still extract useful heat from shallower depth or lower temperature sources, which is more suitable for direct heating purposes. Additionally, both countries have strong commitment for renewable energy and have developed policies and incentives to promote the use of geothermal energy for heating purposes, aligning with their broader sustainability goals. Universities across the globe are embracing geothermal energy as a key element of their sustainable incentives. A growing trend has emerged, with campuses swapping conventional energy sources for geothermal heating and cooling systems. This shift not only reduces carbon emissions, but also serves as a learning opportunity for students who are actively engaging in exploring innovative solutions for environmental challenges. Governments are also stepping up their efforts to promote geothermal energy as part of the decarbonization strategies. The US Department of Energy, DOE, has identified geothermal heat pumps as a pathway to decarbonize heating and cooling systems, paving the way for widespread adoption in residential and commercial buildings. One such initiative is the Frontier Observatory for Research of Geothermal Energy, FORGE, which aims to accelerate the development of enhanced geothermal systems. Projects like FORGE are instrumental in unlocking the full potential of geothermal energy resources. Innovation is driving the evolution of geothermal energy, with startups leading the charge in developing groundbreaking technologies. Companies like Sage, Vulcan Energy, and Quaise Energy are revolutionizing the way we harness geothermal energy, making it more accessible and cost-effective than ever before. The mission of startup founders is to unlock the vast potential of geothermal energy by leveraging advanced drilling technologies and geophysical exploration methods. These innovations have the potential to transform the geothermal industry, making it a mainstream energy solution in the fight against climate change. Big tech companies are also diving into the geothermal sector, recognizing its importance in achieving their sustainability goals. Google, in particular, has made significant investments in geothermal energy projects, signaling a shift towards renewable energy sources in the tech industry. With their expertise and resources, these companies are driving innovation and scaling up geothermal energy production, providing the pathway for a cleaner and greener future. So, what about the financial aspect of geothermal energy? As interests in renewable energy stocks grows, geothermal energy stocks are gaining traction amongst investors looking to capitalize on the transition to clean energy. Geothermal energy stocks offer a promising opportunity for investors seeking exposure to the renewable energy sector. With advancement in technology and supportive governmental policies, the future looks bright for geothermal investments. Whether you're an investor looking to diversify your portfolio or a business seeking sustainable energy solutions, geothermal energy presents a compelling opportunity to drive positive change while generating returns. In conclusion, one thing becomes abundantly clear: the potential of geothermal energy is vast. With innovation, collaboration, and commitment, we can and will harness the power of the Earth to build a cleaner and greener future. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great time and see you in the next one. Bye.
This is gonna be a recording without any exit. Yeah! Are you ready?